Hi folks, I'm Sean McCormick from Lightroom Blog, and in this video we're going to look at profiles in Lightroom. In this video we're going to talk about profiles. Profiles are an alternative render from the camera sensor that are meant to emulate styles, modes or film emulations that are inside the camera. You can normally set these in the camera menus and get a particular look for your images. You can do this in Lightroom also. They're very important because they allow you to have a completely different look, like I say, a completely different render from the sensor. So if we go to Develop module, you might think that something that's this important would be in the basic panel, but it's not. It's actually in the camera calibration panel. And under the process version, we have profile. So as we can see here, we have an Adobe standard profile. Now, different camera systems will have different profiles, and I'm going to show you some from different camera systems. So we have camera muted, camera natural, camera portrait, camera vivid, and this is for an Olympus file. Now, these other ones here are files that are there for profiles from the Visco preset series that I happen to have installed on this machine as well. Now, in this case here, we're going to go for camera vivid because it is one of the native ones to the Olympus. And instantly you can see a big change in the colors. They've all popped a lot more. If we went for a muted tone, we can see they're a little bit more muted. Natural, they get flatter, and in portrait a little bit more of a lift. But vivid works really well for landscapes. So the next file that I have is a Canon Raw File, a CR2 file. And again, if we go Adobe Standard, these ones are marked with camera, are camera faithful. Camera landscape, which is fantastic on Canons. Camera neutral, which is quite muted. Camera portrait, which is a little bit more saturated and probably has a little bit of red tones in it as well. And then camera standard, which is meant to emulate how it looks out of the camera when you shoot a Canon RAW file. So if we go back to camera landscape for this one here, we can see that it's made a massive difference to how the file looks. Now you can see this file is pretty much unedited. There's even spots still on it. So I'm going to go to a Fuji file now. Now this particular file doesn't have a lot of color in it, so it's not necessarily going to jump very much. But the difference with Fuji is that we have film emulations. Now they're down here with camera before it, and the camera is basically the precursor for most of the Adobe profiles. Again, some of these are ones I've created, and some of them are ones like this red blue swap is one that I've downloaded for infrared files. But in this case, the standard would be Provia, which as you can see is a lot more contrasty than the Adobe standard. Velvia would be the vivid mode, which adds more blues and greens. Asti is a soft mode, which lightens it a little bit. Classic Chrome is kind of a muted retro kind of a look. Then you have Pro Negative High and Pro Negative Standard. So the difference between them is just the contrast. Then you have some monochrome ones as well. So as you can see, the profile is really, really important and allows you a better selection of color than you might have directly. As we've seen, especially in the case of the camera landscape from the Canon, the difference between it and the Adobe standard makes it so important that really should probably be up in the basic panel. It's probably one of the first settings that you should consider making if you're doing landscapes. Hey folks, hope you enjoyed that now. If you did, hit the thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and hit the notifications bell if you want to get notified every time there's a new video. Going to be putting stuff out most weekdays, so thanks for watching.